Ah, cocktails at sunset and crystal green waters. These are definitely your views when you're cruising. But as many of you know, this is currently what we look like. We've spent the summer hauled out at the Pensacola shipyard with Perdido Sailor doing some very awesome stuff to our boat. Our list of projects, and as many of you know, they grow as you get in there, but primarily was to drop and reinforce the rudder, fix an issue we were having with our transmission shaft key, change to a composting head if we could fit it, and change out the mixing elbow on the engine, as well as anything else we could do while we were there, but those were the primaries. We got started, we spent 5 weeks hauled out, and it was definitely a beneficial and educational time on the boat. But you have to know that while we're doing all that hard, sweaty, greasy work, this is what's going through our minds. Follow along, crew, as we prepare to weigh anchor in Spanish Wells, follow a captain through the coral-ridden Devil's Backbone, over to Harbour Island and Eleuthera. We'll share the beautiful pink shores on the Atlantic side, explore the very cool little town that is Harbour Island, and spend 3 days kiting on the harbor side with some new friends we met who are also there on their boat, although it's a bit of a different kind. Yes, billionaires with a B. But they were way cool and so much fun to hang out with. Our last night in Spanish Wells, we were blessed with a gorgeous sunset, and we always love to tuck in on the boat and cook a nice dinner aboard. Wine and risotto it was that evening, and we were preparing to leave the next day, so I got up early and jumped in the water and did a little prop check before we left.
Okay, cool. Ready?
And engine smog on this turn. I clean that area about every couple days when we're really cruising, but it's totally worth it. I'm a bit of a neataholic on the boat, and for good reason.
I'm the cleaner.
Here we're inflating our below decks Achilles dinghy. Phillip and I like to travel with a dinghy that can stow completely below because we like a clean deck for offshore voyages. It's fairly easy. We use a foot pump and insertable wooden floorboards for the rigidity. It's got just an inflatable keel, which isn't perfect. It can't plane out, but we're definitely pleased with this dinghy for our boat. Thank you. All right, time to weigh anchor. Phillip and I often try to reverse roles where he's at the bow or I'm at the helm and swap back and forth so we both get a feel of the difficulties of each position. That morning, we had hired a captain who had come to the boat and was going to take us through the devil's backbone. We saw many huge ships having a captain take them through the coral head, so we thought that would be a smart way to do it our first time through. Here's where we are, Eleuthera, and I'll show you exactly why the devil's backbone is so tricky. You'll see here all of the coral heads that litter the path. While it's not that difficult of a route to make, if you know where you're going, we certainly did not. And the captains there know exactly where to go and how to avoid all of the treacherous rocks below.
Devil's backbone.
The devil right here. Devil's in the details.
You'll see here a lot of the many, many mega yachts that are making their way into Harbour Island. We did not know it, but this is definitely a hub for the huge monster yachts.
All three of those mega yachts.
While it did feel a little strange to travel with our deep sailboat so close to shore, we trusted our captain and it was definitely a beautiful motor day. Once they get you into the safer waters inside Harbour Island, the captain simply rafts up close by, gets his fee, it costs $120, and he sends you on his way. We were then free to try to navigate ourselves, hopefully without the need of a captain, to get around the shoals and where we wanted to drop the hook behind Harbour Island. And as I've said many times, while we did use the electronic navionics charts, we relied very heavily on the paper explorer charts. They were hyper accurate throughout all the Bahamas. We were excited to see that it was blowing in Harbour Island because we definitely wanted to kite. A quick anchor check though first, and we were gonna head off to snorkel near Man's Island. Okay, we found our spot. It's time to get under the sea. And this lovely boat behind us turned out to be another fun young cruising couple, Life in the Key of C. Don't worry, we'll catch up with them later. All I need is you. day two at Harbour Island, and it was time to go ashore and explore. I love all these Bahamian islands where everything is so colorful and quaint. And this was the promised pink sand beach on the North Atlantic shore. It wasn't perfectly pink, but definitely close up you could tell there was a rosy hue to the sand. And the horseback riding was a bit touristy, but still beautiful to see horses near the water. Didn't take long. Phillip saw a kite in the sky and our shore leave was over. It was time to launch these kites and get on the wind.
He's so excited, he's running around, look at him. Woo! Wild man. Man, you're in paradise. Bye babe, have fun, be careful.
Our second full day in Harbour Island, we went back ashore and thankfully got to hitch a ride on a golf cart with some fellow cruisers. It's really cool in those areas that you don't see the big monster mega vehicles. A lot of people are on bikes and golf carts. There were also several nice resorts and upscale restaurants in the area. It was just a really fun place to explore and a great place to eat. We went out hiking also that day with Brett and Kristen on Life in the Key of the Sea and had a really cool time just poking around and checking out the views on the south side of the island. I know what you're thinking. You hear that wind. So did Phillip, and it was time to get back on the kites. This time we found some folks out there who we were kiting with. They were very humble, but they told us we're here on the biggest boat in the harbor, and they definitely were flying high. But I can't really give this boat justice by talking about it. You just have to see. Ready? They were super humble though. We swapped out gear and taught each other tricks, but they were definitely higher up on the get a little crazy scale. These two love to just monkey around all day. But I'm gonna go out on a limb and say Phillip and I definitely held our own. Let's go get them, Josh. Hey, hey, hey. Watch here, he's about to launch from his leash, and Phillip's in the background trying to give him some competition. Okay, show me what you got, babe. Words slurring, engine purring. Mommy front, but I'm so determined. Shots up a drone, now she in the zone. I ain't talking about the 2-3. Mommy in the zone like the homie 2-3. Jordan and chain, make no difference. A crisp new kite and busted the bladder, but I'm sure they had three more on order. They're billionaires, right? Doesn't matter to us though. You don't have to be rich to have fun. Next time, we'll take you over to the berries for some more sporty underwater activity. Be ready to dive in. Stay tuned. Screener right here. He's gonna get me all taken care of because I'm getting a little red. Can you tell?